Hi everybody, it's Brian here. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. So in today's episode, we're going to be looking at how we can use Canva to create some eye-catching, scroll-stopping advertisements in order to help promote our TeePublic designs. As many of you know, the first 72 hours of a design's new life on TeePublic is going to be on sale on basically any and all the products that you have activated for that particular design. Now, most customers don't know about this, so the best way to obviously inform them about it is by creating advertisements that you can use in your social media posts to let them know. Most people are always all about looking for a sale to try and save a little bit of money, and the idea is that obviously if you get people to jump over to your shop, maybe perhaps purchase one of your designs whilst it's on sale, it might actually lead them to become a repeat customer to your shop. So even though the first sale for that particular customer might not get you the most in terms of royalties, the potential of getting them to come back to your shop over and over again to buy designs new and old can obviously help to increase your profit margins. So with that said, let's head over to my computer now so that I can show you how you can use Canva to create a really great advertisement to showcase some of your recent designs on TeePublic for on your social media platforms. Let's get to it. Okay, everybody, welcome to my computer screen. And as you can see here, I'm on my TeePublic store. And basically what I want to do is I want to grab six of my most recent designs that I just obviously created, uploaded. I want to start, you know, advertising them to people who follow me on the various social media platforms that I upload to. And what I don't want to do is I don't want to have to go through the hassle of taking a full-size screenshot of everything and then going into Photoshop, you know, pasting it in there and then just cropping out the parts that I want for my advertisement. So on Windows, there is an actual keyboard shortcut key that you can use to effectively take a screenshot of just a part of your screen. Now, basically, all you need to press and hold are the following keys: Windows, Shift, and the letter S. So if I press them now, Windows, Shift, and the letter S, we're gonna see that my screen has grayed out. And that's absolutely fine. There's nothing wrong with your screen. There's nothing wrong with your monitor, so don't panic. Now what I wanna do is I wanna just grab my mouse and I want to navigate. Let's say I want to take this particular design over here. So I'm just gonna put the crossbar here on the top left-hand corner of that design, and I'm gonna drag it out all the way down to the bottom right-hand corner. And when I let it go, Windows is going to save a screenshot of this particular portion of my screen in the clipboard. So I'm going to let go. My screen has come back to its normal luminances, and I'm going to go now into Canva, and I've already opened up a canvas size of 1080 by 1080 pixels, which is basically the canvas size that I really enjoy using for various social media platforms. Obviously, Pinterest, you do need to make it slightly different given the fact that they're more vertical, it's stretched out. But effectively, if you do want to create something like what I'm creating today for Pinterest, the methods to go about doing it is effectively the same as what I'm going to be showing over here. So now that I have that design in the clipboard, all I need to do is just click anywhere in the white area here and hit Control V on the keyboard, and it's going to paste it. So we now see that we have the first design on the canvas. Now we're gonna go back to TeePublic, and I wanna grab this one down over here, the one pertaining to coffee. So again, I'm gonna press and hold the Windows, Shift, and the letter S key. The screen grays out, and now I'm just gonna highlight the area, let go, and now it's saved in the clipboard. I'm gonna go back to my canvas on Canva and hit Control V on the keyboard, and now I've got those two designs pasted on my canvas. Now I want to use six designs for this particular advert. Now I've already went ahead and extrapolated the designs that I want to use for this video so that this video won't be very long, and I already have them on page two over here. Now they're obviously all different sizes, and what we want to do is we want to try and lay them out so that obviously they're going to be the same size, it's going to look balanced, we'll add a little bit of text and a little bit of background color to effectively make a nice eye-appealing scroll-stopping advertisement. So how are we going to go about doing that when we've got all of these different graphics, different sizes? Well, it's very simple to do. Let's just add another page here so that we're always working on a nice clean canvas Don't worry about the graphics above. We're going to drag them down when we're ready to use them. So what I want to do first is I want to use the frame function on Canva to help me lay out my design in the most efficient way possible and to make sure that obviously everything is going to be balanced. So what we're going to do is we're just going to open up our tools area here, and I already went to grids, and what we're going to select is this grid over here that's 3x3. So I'm just going to click on it. And obviously we now have 9 squares, but hey, wait a minute, we're only using 6 graphics. Don't worry about it, I've got you covered. So the first thing we want to do is we want to make sure that we get rid of all of these spaces between the squares. So in order to do that, we're going to click on spacing and we're going to take the grid spacing down all the way to 0. So once we've done that, all of those white lines have now disappeared. Now, because of the fact that I only want to use 6 squares, I could put the designs into the first 6 squares, but if I had to drag it down, these bottom 3 are still going to be a bit of a problem, but I won't be able to delete the bottom 3 thereafter. So what I'm going to do, there's a way around this. I'm going to scroll all the way back up to the grids, and I'm going to select the single frame, and I'm just going to bring it on, and it's already huge, but don't worry about it. What we're going to do is I'm going to grab the bottom handle, and I'm going to resize it to make sure that it covers over the first one. Now, once I have that laid out and I'm happy with it, all I do is hit Control D on the keyboard to duplicate it. And I'm just going to move it and place it in place. And I know that I have it right where I need it to be because Canva helps me out with these guidelines here. And then we're going to create another one and just drag that into place as well. Now, I want to do this 3 more times. So Control D. And we'll place it on the second row. Control D again. Place it in the middle. Okay, then we hit Control D a final time, and we're going to put the last square in place. Now that I have those 6 squares in place, I don't need the ones beneath anymore, so I'm just going to click on it and hit Delete. Okay, so now before I actually go ahead and put the graphics in, I want to place these frames in the appropriate place on the canvas. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to left click outside of the canvas, drag to make sure that I highlight all of them, and then what I'm going to do is just I'm going to move everything down here, and I'm going to take it, let's say just a little bit. Yeah, that seems about right. Okay, again, we can always move it thereafter. All right, now I'm going to click outside. And now what I want to do is I want to start bringing in the graphics. So let's just go to the top here. And we've got this first one. We're just going to drag it down and place it into the first square. And as you can see, automatically, Canva puts it into the frame. Okay, now I just want to go up to the next page and bring out the next graphic. So it's this one here. So I'm just going to grab it down and place it into the frame on the right-hand side. And now what I want to do is I want to put one of my graphics, it has a different color in it, so it's just not all black. And I've got this one here, which I'm going to click and drag. Okay, original bad firefighter. Okay, and then it's just a question of grabbing the other 3. Now the other last 3, I've got 2 with a colored background and 1 with a black background. So the colored ones are going to go 1, 2 on either side. So we're just going to click and drag that down over here. All right, just delete that. And then we'll grab the purple one and place it accordingly there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to grab this one down here. We'll bring it down, continue bringing it down. And we'll just drag that accordingly. Okay, so now that we have our designs properly placed where we would like it on the canvas, it's time to actually start filling in the blank areas. Now, what I want to do first and foremost is I want to create sort of like a colorful emblem with the price of the teas, so that obviously it'd be eye-catching and will grab people's attention. So again, what we're going to do now is we're going to go on to elements, and I went ahead and I typed in the word sale. Obviously Canva obviously presented me with all these various graphics, and given the fact that I am using a free version of Canva, obviously some of these particular clip arts and graphics are not accessible to me. But again, that's okay. If you are using the free version of Canva like I am, there are tons of clip arts that you can still use to obviously make a great advertisement. And in fact, we've got this sort of orangey red emblem out over here, which I think with a black background is really going to stand out. So we're going to click on that and bring it into place. Now, I want this emblem to feature in the top right hand corner. So I'm going to drag it up here and I'm going to resize it a little bit so that obviously it doesn't cover any part of the graphics. So just bring that up a little bit over here. And now what I want to do is I want to put some text over here. Now again, given the fact that I stated earlier on in this episode that for the first 72 hours of a design being uploaded onto TeePublic on a t-shirt, instead of $20, it's going to be on sale for $14. So we want to make sure that we're highlighting that, because people are always on the lookout for great deals, particularly if they need to buy a bunch of gifts and you obviously they want to save some money. So what we're going to do is we're going to hit T on the keyboard to bring up the text, get those crossbars and drag it up over here above the emblem. We'll double click inside it and then we'll just type in the dollar sign, $14 space, capital letters, T's with an exclamation mark. And we'll just increase the size of the text here. Now I'm using Armo as a font, but I want something a little bit darker and bolder. So let's just click down here and let's choose Public Sans Bold. Yeah, okay, that works for me. Now what we'll do is just grab the handle here and drag it up a little bit, resize it. And what I'm gonna do is I wanna get rid of some of that space between the $14 and T's. So we'll just select all of it and then we'll click on this spacing icon here and drag the line spacing down a little bit, bring them a little bit closer. Okay, it works out for me. And now what we'll do is we'll just click outside so that we can click back in and move everything over until we get the purple lines that Canva obviously provides us, telling us that we are centered both horizontally and vertically. So that works great. Now let's change the background color of the canvas to black. So we're just gonna click anywhere on the white. We'll click on the color icon here and we'll choose black as our background color. Okay, so this is already looking really good. Now, what we want to do is we want to bring in the TeePublic logo. Now, you can get the TeePublic logo simply by just doing a Google search, type in TeePublic logo, PNG, transparent background, and Google will obviously show you a ton of different samples or options that you could choose. Find one that you like, and obviously you can save it accordingly. I've already done so, so I'm going to bring it in. Now, I have it in white because obviously I want it's to contrast against my black background. So I'm gonna drag that in, wait for Canva to load it up, and then we're just gonna click and we're gonna drag it up to the top over here. And we'll resize it accordingly, okay, so that it'll really stand out nicely. It'll be clear, it won't be foggy at all. Okay, so now the next thing we wanna do, that given the fact that it is an introductory design advertisement or announcement, so let's let them know. So we're just gonna hit on text, T for text, and we'll just grab that up over here. Okay, and let's just highlight it all and we'll type something like introductory design sale. Okay, and what we'll do is we'll stretch this out a little bit. That's fine, but I want to increase the size of it so that we'll have introductory design on one line and sale on the next. So we'll just click that. All right. And we'll just bring that up a little bit here. So TeePublic introductory design sale, $14 T's, all right? And then down at the bottom over here, what we'll do is we'll hit T again to bring the text bar up and we'll just drag that down. And then what we're gonna do is we're going to also include some other products that you have allocated for your designs on your TeePublic shop. Maybe perhaps, you know, products that you sell really well. So let's just type in hoodies. And then we'll just do a hyphen, stickers, hyphen, don't worry about that. We'll just drag that out. Okay, mugs, and then we'll hit the space. Now, obviously given the fact that the sale is only for 72 hours, we need to tell them. So we're just gonna do 72 hours. All right, and what we'll do now is we'll decrease the size of the font. We'll hit Control A to select all, and we'll just decrease the font so that obviously it stands out on one line, and we'll drag it down a little bit. Whatever, I mean, you can actually put in whatever text that you want. It's gonna be different for everybody. And obviously, you will actually put in what you want to put based on the circumstance of the sale. So whether or not it's a TeePublic sale that's gonna be happening right across the board with everybody's shops, or whether it's something like this, which is pertaining to obviously, you know, your introductory designs that you want to let them know about. So whatever text you want to embed into your advert, it's totally up to you. But as you can see here, given the fact that we've got our designs showcased here, we've got a little bit of color, particularly in the emblem, we've got the white text contrasting against the black background, well, obviously that's going to stand out, and obviously it's going to be very eye-appealing and probably will get people to stop scrolling, you know, in their feet to take a look a little bit more at the designs and what the sale is all about, because everybody loves a good sale. So now it's just a question of downloading, and then obviously once I've downloaded it into my computer, I can then go ahead and obviously upload it to my various social media accounts that obviously I upload to. So as you can see here, it's really not that difficult to create an effective advertisement on Canva. In fact, once you actually create your first template, let's call this a template, it's very simple just to switch out these designs with other new designs as you create them, and maybe just tweak the text a little bit so that it's always looking fresh, it doesn't always look the same, and then simply just uploading it accordingly to your social media accounts, wherever it is that you upload to, and you can really go to town with creating some really great designs. So I really hope that you enjoyed this episode. I hope that you learned a lot from it. If you did, do me a favor and smash that like button. And if you're new to the channel, please do consider subscribing and hitting the bell notification icon so that you'll be informed each and every time that I upload a new video to my channel. I'm really striving hard to reach 3,000 subscribers by the end of this calendar year. So it would be really great if you could join me in my community. But for today, that's all I've got. And as always, be safe, be well, be creative. Bye for now. Hey, if you enjoyed this video and you want to find out more ways that you can take your print-on-demand business to the next level, why don't you check out one of these two episodes I have over here. And don't forget to subscribe. Catch you in the next episode. Bye for now.